No real answers coming in from financial technologies promoter Jignesh Shah. The NSCL crackdown gets tougher with now reports indicating that the government is looking at halting all operations of the spot exchange, including the e-contracts. For more on this story that has developed over the last 1 week, G. Chandrasekhar, commodities editor at the Hindu Business Line, now joins us on this conversation. Chandrasekhar, many thanks for joining us. Let me begin by asking you about what you made of this entire story. You know, how is it a spot exchange was allowed to run illegal futures contract? What does this mean to commodities trading that has developed so far? What have you read of this?
It's like this. Rightly or wrongly, permission was given to this spot exchange to run spot contracts. Spot contracts under the Forward Contract Regulation Act, called Ready Delivery Contract, mean that when a commodity is traded, the delivery and payment must be completed within 11 days. And these ready delivery contracts are outside the purview of the Forward Contract Regulation Act. Therefore, this exchange got permission to trade only spot contracts, where the intention was for the farmers to come and deliver their goods, and there'll be traders or commission agents or buyers who will buy these goods and pay the farmer, and the buyer will take the cargo away. This is the intention of the spot market. On a daily basis, producers would come and deliver their cargo. Buyers interested in buying the cargo would come, take delivery, make payment, and the transaction would be complete. This is how it started. The intention was very laudable. But over a period of time, it actually began to degenerate when financial investors started to enter this market. And when financial investors started to enter this market, you had contract called T plus 2. It is transaction on a particular day, and within the next 2 days, settlement and payment will have to be completed, and delivery will have to be completed. When financial engineers of this country entered this market, it got actually corrupted. They also had a paired contract called T2 and T25. And therefore, the T25 contract is transaction to be completed within 25 days, technically, is a forward contract. Under the Forward Contract Regulation Act, as I said, a ready delivery contract, delivery and payment must be made within 11 days. Anything that happens beyond 11 days, either delivery or payment or both happen beyond 11 days, is technically a forward contract. And a forward contract comes under the purview of the Forward Contract Regulation Act, and the Forward Markets Commission is a regulator for this market. Therefore, it started with good intention, T plus 2, to help farmers, to help help growers bring their produce to the spot exchange, sell, take the money home. Sure. But over a period of time, it got cut. Forward contracts were introduced in addition to spot contracts.
Sure.
And that's how the whole thing expanded. And a lot of financial engineers came into this market. And you know the current position.